Hi friends, Mr. Normanton here, here with the second episode of Who Were the Beatles? In this episode, we'll learn about John Lennon, one of the Beatles. Chapter 1, John Lennon. There was nothing quiet about John Lennon, not even the day he was born. It was October 9th, 1940. World War II was raging in Europe. Liverpool, England was being bombed by the Germans, but baby John couldn't wait. His mother, Julia, went to the hospital and gave birth at 7 in the morning. As he arrived, the walls of the hospital shook from falling bombs. Even before the war, Liverpool was a gloomy place to live. Once a thriving seaport, the rain-soaked city had become run down. Many factories were closing, and those that remained open didn't have enough jobs. Poor families were crammed into small apartments in the slums of town. At first, John lived with his mother and grandparents. John's father, Alfred, was never around. He worked on a ship and was gone for months on end. As hard as she tried, John's mother couldn't make enough money to support her baby son. For little over a year, Alfred sent checks home. Then the checks stopped, and Alfred stopped writing. Julia couldn't afford to get John his own bed. He ended up sleeping in hers. Things grew worse. John's family began to fight over where he should live. Julia wanted him to stay with her. He was her son, but she had trouble taking care of him. John's aunt Mimi wanted the boy. She said that John would be better off with her. Mimi lived in a big house in a better part of town. John's father tried to take him too. One weekend, John went to visit his father, whose boat had docked in Liverpool. Alfred asked the boy, only 5 years old at the time, if he wanted to go on an adventure. They would travel together to a faraway country called New Zealand. Sure, said John. That sounded like fun. Then Julia found out what Alfred was planning. She told him to stay away. But much as she wanted John, Julia saw that her son needed a better home. In the end, she decided to send him to Mimi. Despite all of this, John was a happy boy. Pictures from those days show him with a big smile on his face, whether he was riding his bike or standing with the family dog, Sally. Mimi gave him lots of books. Along with reading, John liked to make monsters and skeletons out of paper and paste them all over his bed. Because John was so young, he really didn't know it was unusual to live with his aunt and to have his mother visit. Besides, Julia acted more like a buddy than a mother. She loved to tell jokes, make funny faces, and sing. She taught John how to play the banjo, an instrument similar to the guitar. From Julia, John heard stories about his banjo-playing grandfather who had moved to the United States. It was John's mother who first gave him his guitar. She taught him how to play it. Aunt Mimi had a lot of rules. She expected John to come home after school to do homework. Then she wanted him to get to bed early. She often had a good reason to get mad at John. As he got older, John got into more and more trouble. He was smart, but he didn't work hard. He only did really well in art class. He spent most of his time making little books and poems and drawings. He got in fights with other kids. That's too bad. Perhaps he was acting up out of sadness. A few months before his 18th birthday, Julia was hit by a car and she died. That was his mom. John was heartbroken. Years later, he wrote a song called Julia about her. As a teenager, one thing John got serious about was music. When he was 15, he heard rock and roll for the first time. Until then, most music was heard on the radio was soft music, sung by such stars as Perry Como and Doris Day. Rock was different. The music was loud. It had a strong beat you could jump around to. Many grown-ups hated it. Teenagers loved it. Rock had exciting stars. John's favorite singer was Elvis Presley. Elvis was from Tulupo, Mississippi. Tulupio. He had thick black hair, which he slicked up with grease and wore his shirt. And he would dance around. And when Elvis sang, the girls went crazy and boys admire him. But many adults thought he was a bad influence. When Elvis went on television, all the boys and girls went a little crazy. Elvis Presley, and I'm going to talk a little bit about Elvis Presley right there. Born in Mississippi, Elvis Presley was the first real rock and roll star. He was a white singer who captured the sound of African-American blues musicians. There were other white singers who did this too, But Elvis was the most exciting. Elvis recorded his first song in 1953, My Happiness. He paid for it himself as a gift to his mother. For a while, he worked in a machine shop and drove a truck. Eventually, he was discovered. His hits included Hound Dog, Heartbreak Hotel. As he became more popular, people stopped calling him Elvis. Instead, he became the king of rock and roll. John started dressing like Elvis, right down to the greasy hair. He also decided to play guitar. Mimi did not approve. She wanted John to take piano or violin lessons and wouldn't pay for the guitar lessons. John kept the guitar anyway. He was a natural. Soon, John formed his own band at school. It was called the Quarrymen. Still, Mimi wouldn't let him in the house with his new instrument. John had to practice outside in the garden. A guitar is all right, Mimi told him, but you'll never earn a living by doing it. And that's all about John Lennon. Next chapter, chapter 2, episode 3, will be about Paul McCartney.